Previously, the group jumped into the fight against the necromancer. Will used a tome shoved it in by Lacey to create an aura around him that dispelled the mist so that they could see who they were fighting. Lacey quickly discovered to her displeasure that the conjured undead weren't affected by cold damage, while Obsidian was thrilled to realize that they did in fact have problems with necrotic damage. The necromancer cast silence around the group, limiting some of them for a bit, before Will hit him with multiple magic missiles back to back and broke his concentration. Arryn noticed two cultists at the far ends of the room keeping the mist up and shouted out a warning. The fight continued, with the necromancer shooting chill touch at anyone and everyone he could. Several more traditional undead thralls joined the fight, and Lacey focused on them since her element of choice was cold, which didn't do much against the conjured undead. Obsidian was hit by one of the thralls when intentionally moving away, and immediately turned them to ash with a hellish rebuke. Then they healed themselves, which turned out to have been a good decision, as the next attack that hit them was of the critical type. Will went down, and the mist began rolling back in. They couldn't heal him because of the chill touch that took him down, but Arryn was able to cast Spare the Dying on him. Ingrid grabbed the book that Will had dropped and kept running forward into the fray. She didn't have a chance to use it, so Lacey grabbed the book from her and put it to use. Arryn got Will back to consciousness. Obsidian rushed up to the necromancer, all bubbly and excited to be in the presence of a master. Then they used Inflict Wounds plus their touch of damage to do a shit ton of necrotic damage against him. It didn't take him down, but it was clearly very close. The two of them had a moment, both of them embracing their love of death, before he cast Lightning Bolt at them, Lacey, and Will. Thanks to Arryn lowering the damage slightly, none of them died outright, but both Obsidian and Lacey went unconscious. Will managed to stay on his feet, and he used the book again to remove the mist. Arryn got Obsidian back to their feet, and then they took down the necromancer by breaking his neck with a spectral fish. Yeah, I've got nothing. The rest of the fight went quickly, and Ingrid managed to get Lacey conscious again before any permanent damage was done. They also got a good look at the arm that Lacey usually kept covered in its icy glory. After searching the room for any and all evidence that they could possibly gather, they made their way back up to the streets above. They found themselves in a closed cafe, which led to them catching the attention of the guards, as the group was many things, but stealthy wasn't one of them. Just as they were about to get arrested, the de facto leader of the Thorn Shard Syndicate showed up and essentially claimed them. The group was told to provide as much evidence as they could and explain how they found out what was going on in the sewers before the syndicate did. Like it or not, they had definitely gotten their attention, although they were at least forgiven for the earlier incident with them helping someone who was trying to cut into the syndicate's profit. They headed off to get some rest after promising to provide the requested information and proof. And that is where the mini-campaign ended. At least until the next time the DM needs a break, at which point we'll probably dip back into this world.